Hey everyone, and welcome back to another great eShop deals video, where each and every week we go through all the deals on the eShop and I pick out which would be my top picks for the week. Now this week we've got another massive list of over 20 games, primarily because the Bandai Namco sale is back, with most of their titles being at the lowest price ever. Also, just a quick reminder in case you're new to the channel or the series, I don't go over the deals that were mentioned in last week's video. So if you want to make sure that you're not missing out on any games because some deals do last more than a week, make sure you check out last week's video as well. Now, for all of you that participated, about halfway through the video, we'll also be announcing this week's winner of the $5 eShop gift card. If ever you're wondering how you can participate in future weeks, all you have to do is check out my under $5 eShop deals video that normally comes out midweek. And finally, one last little item before we get started. If you're looking for E3 coverage, I most likely will be posting videos over the next few days, and they might be coming out at odd hours. So make sure your notifications are on. Don't forget that if you do like all this content, best way to support the channel, hit the like button and subscribe if you aren't already. Now this week we are starting out very strong, with the first game being This War of Mine, the Complete Edition, at 90% off for only $3.99. Now this is a wartime game, but told from a perspective that we're not used to in gaming. Rather than being an armed-to-the-teeth soldier fighting your way through a war zone, you're playing as a normal civilian, just trying to survive while a war is going on around you. You have to scavenge for food, take care of shelter. It is an amazing game told from a perspective that we're not used to seeing in gaming. If you're going to pick up one game only this week and you want to take a chance, I definitely say that This War of Mine should be top on your list. Now next on our list is the Overcooked series. Now the whole series is on sale, and this is one of my favorite all-time party games. Only, as I say every time, fair warning, if you play with people with tempers, it can flare up sometimes in these games. Now, we're not going to go look at each one of the entries in the series individually. My top pick would be Overcooked 2 at $12.49 because it is 50% off. However, if you want a cheap entry into the series, the first one is only $4.99 currently. It is the same game, although the second one is more refined with more alternatives and overall more content. So next on the list, we have a new entry to the series. We have Taiko no Tatsujin that is 80% off, dropping it to only $9.99. Now this is a drumming rhythm-based game, and honestly, it is tons of fun and very, very addictive. However, once again, it is best played if you actually have the physical drum. But then again, you can play with Joy-Cons as well. So don't feel like it's an obligation. It plays very well with the Joy-Cons. It's just that the best fun you can have is if you do pick up eventually the physical drum. But at only $9.99, this is an excellent time to try out this game and see if you want to later invest in the hardware. Now next on the list, we have My Time at Portia that is 75% off at $7.49. Now, a few weeks ago, it showed up for the first time on the list because the deal finally got so good. If you were ever looking at a game that was sort of like Animal Crossing, but with a little more diversity, a little combat, a little exploration, well, My Time at Portia would be an excellent pickup. At its full price, however, there were some glitches and some little hiccups here and there, but at $7.49, it becomes an excellent pickup in my book. Next, we have another one of my personal top picks for this week, and this is Blasphemous. That is 60% off, dropping it to $9.99. Now, this is an awesome gothic-styled action-adventure Metroidvania. Fair warning though, it becomes extremely difficult. This is one of those situations where if you don't have a tolerance for difficult games, this game is not for you. However, if you do enjoy a challenge, you will probably be very satisfied with Blasphemous. I love the gothic style of this game and the overall atmosphere that it drives. If you need any convincing or you want to try it out for yourself, there's also a free downloadable demo. Now next on the list, we have Little Nightmares that is 75% off for only $7.49. Now this is a really creepy puzzle platformer. Fair warning, the controls sometimes can be a little wonky, which is why this game at $30, I would say I would always wait for a sale. But at $7.49, if you like puzzle platformers, especially if you like creepy aesthetics, do yourself a favor, pick up Little Nightmares. It is a dream pickup. The second one is also on sale, but is only very slightly on sale, and I personally would still wait for it to be more heavily discounted before picking it up. But for the first one at 75%, no brainer. Now next on our list, we have another amazing party game, which is Moving Out, that is once again 50% on sale for $12.49. As the title suggests, this game is all about moving furniture and items out of different locations. Some of them are crazy, like a moving plane floating in space, others are as simple as a house. This is another amazing couch co-op game. Once again, free downloadable demo. If you're looking for this type of game, you won't be disappointed with Moving Out. Now next on our list is going to be The Escapist 2, the Game of the Year Edition. Now this is another series that the whole series is on sale, and we're not going to go into each entry separately because ultimately it is the same gameplay that just evolves from entry to entry. And personally, I would automatically go with the Game of the Year Edition because that's 75% off for $6.74. If you buy the base edition and the DLC later on, it is most likely going to cost you more than just picking up the Game of the Year Edition right away. Ultimately, you play a prisoner in a prison and your point is to break out. You can play this actually alone or in co-op. You can play cooperatively trying to help each other out, or you can do it competitively trying to see who's going to break out first and in different ways. It is an amazing overall game, tons of fun, definite awesome pickup at $6.74. Now next we have a series that often goes overlooked, and that is the Worms series, with Worms WMD at 75% off for $7.49. If you're into strategy games or strategy shooters, the Worms series is an amazing series. Don't be fooled by the fact that they're Worms. They are armed to the teeth, and it is tons of fun to play with the different weapons, the different vehicles, and the crazy stages and locales. This is an amazing strategy game. If you've never tried out a Worms game, at $7.49, it's an excellent time. Now next, we have another returning favorite on the channel, which is Yooka-Laylee, 75% off for $9.99. Look, you're getting an almost first party quality 3D action adventure game for only $10. Yooka-Laylee is an amazing series. It is a spiritual successor to Banjo and Kazooie from the Nintendo 64. If you haven't played it yet and you're into 3D platformers, once again, do yourself a favor, pick this one up at only $9.99. Now next on our list, we have Katamari Damacy, and we're getting into the thick of the Bandai Namco section of the list, but you're gonna see what's awesome is that these are new all-time lows for a lot of these games. And Katamari Damacy Reroll is at 75% off for only $7.49, an amazing laid-back puzzle game to be picked up. Basically, you have to rebuild the universe by rolling balls around the stages and picking up items till they're big enough. Sounds like an out there concept, but trust me, it is tons and tons and tons of fun. If you need convincing for yourself, once again, this one as well has a free downloadable demo. Now next on our list, we have Monster Sanctuary that still has a few days left on its deal at 33% off for $13.39. Now this is a game that I fully reviewed on the channel and that I enjoyed a ton. It is basically Pokemon meets a Metroidvania. However, don't be fooled, it is not just a cheap copy. It really has its own style, with always being 3v3 combat and having a different dimension to the tactics in combat. It is actually much deeper than you think at first. Now, if you're looking in either a Metroidvania or a Pokemon-style trainer game, trust me, Monster Sanctuary at $13.39 most likely will not disappoint. Now, the next game on our list is going to be from the same developers as The Escapists, but this time it is The Survivalists. So it's the same twist of The Escapists, but done to a survival game with some awesome pixel art style. Now, this is a game that I was waiting for a long time to hit that 50% or more sale, because I really find that these games at these prices is when they're really, really worth a pickup. Now, The Survivalists, as I said earlier, is basically a survival game at its heart, but it has an awesome pixel art twist that is tons of fun. Now, if you need convincing, once again, this one, I'm going to say it a lot this week, free downloadable demo. Now, for the regulars on the channel, you probably saw this one coming. The next game is going to be Yooka-Laylee and the Impossible Lair, 75% off for $7.49. Now, the sequel, rather than being a spiritual successor to Banjo-Kazooie, is a spiritual successor to Donkey Kong Country. And these are actually the same developers that worked on Donkey Kong Country, which is why I'm saying you're getting a first-party quality title for only $7.49. And I personally actually preferred this one to Tropical Freeze. If you need any more convincing, once again, free downloadable demo for this one as well. Now next on the list, we have Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 at 50% off for $24.99. Now for all these anime-themed games, it's always going to be the same thing. If you're a fan of the series, these games are amazing pickups. If you have no idea what Naruto is, if you're not into anime, these are probably going to be skips for you. Because basically the fun of these games are playing through the Naruto storylines, but controlling the characters, awesome combats, awesome special effects, but ultimately these are games that are fan service for the fans of the series. And finally, the fourth one at 50% off is in the price range where I'm comfortable recommending it on a regular basis. But if you're a fan of Naruto and you haven't played the earlier ones, there's going to be a better option a little bit later on the list. Now next on the list is going to be Jump Force, the Deluxe Edition. Once again, 50% off for $24.99. Now Jump Force is basically the mashup series for all these different anime genres. And the huge fun of this game is seeing characters that have never basically met each other in the animes, getting to play together with them, fight together with them, and that's what makes this game great. Once again, if you're a fan of a lot of these anime series, this is a great pickup and it's fun to play through. And now at 50% off, it is in the price range once again, where I would say it is definitely worth a pickup. Now next on our list, we have a game that I often skip over, but now with this deal, it is definitely a good pickup. And that is Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 for the Nintendo Switch at 84% off for only $7.99. If you're a fan of Dragon Ball, this is finally the time to definitely pick up this game. I was sort of underwhelmed with this game a little bit. Maybe it's because I'm such a huge fan of Dragon Ball and I want my games to be fantastic. But finally, at $7.99, I would say that anyone who is into Dragon Ball in any way will feel perfectly fine picking this game up for only $8 and playing through the storyline. Now next, we finally have a game for all the JRPG fans. Ni no Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. Now, if you're a JRPG fan and you haven't played this one yet, this, in my opinion, is a definite pickup on the Nintendo Switch. And at 75% off for only $12.49, it is excellent, excellent value. Now, don't be fooled by the childlike graphics or cartoon-like graphics. This becomes a very deep and full RPG with a full storyline and really, really touching storyline as well. So if you're into JRPGs, you haven't played this one yet, do yourself a favor, pick it up. It is an amazing game. So now we're just going to take a break for a couple of seconds to look at this week's winner of the $5 eShop gift card. And this week's winner is going to be Anne Wright with her comment that says, "Always look forward to your sale notifications. Thanks for everything and giving us a chance to pick up a gift card. You rock." I just want to say thank you, Anne, for your awesome comment. And all you have to do to claim your $5 eShop gift card is reach out to me in my pinned comment below in this video. So now the next entry on our list is that other Naruto game that I mentioned earlier, which is Naruto Shippuden The Ultimate Ninja Storm Trilogy, which is once again at its lowest price ever, only $15.99. Now basically you're getting all three of the first Naruto Shippuden games in this pack. So if you're a fan of Naruto and you haven't played any of the games yet, before picking up the fourth one, I would definitely pick up this pack. You get so much content and so much gameplay for only $16 that in my book, it is definitely worth a pickup. Now the next entry on my list is going to be for retro arcade fans with the Namco Museum Archives Volume 1 at its lowest price ever, $4.99. Now you get 11 arcade classics for only $5. My favorite among these are going to be Mappy, Dig Dug, Pac-Man, and also Splatterhouse Wampaku Graffiti, which is basically a game that was limited to Japan for a long time, but we finally have on this collection. Honestly, for only $5, if you haven't picked up this collection yet and you love these arcade classics, I would say now's the best time to pull the trigger. Now the next game on our list is going to be an anime-themed game, but this is probably the first one that I'm saying you don't have to be a fan of Dragon Ball to like. Dragon Ball FighterZ Ultimate Edition, 84% off for $17.59. And I'm focusing on the Ultimate Edition because the DLC characters you get are really, really worth it. And if you get into the game, you're going to want to purchase them anyway, and it's going to cost you way more to buy them separately. But they basically, Dragon Ball FighterZ, what is so great about it is it's not only Dragon Ball themed and for fans, it is an amazing fighting game at heart. It has an amazing community. It is super easy to pick up, but yet really, really hard to master and get to the highest levels in the game. So if you haven't picked this one up yet, I would definitely say that $17.59 for the Ultimate Edition is an amazing deal. Now next, we have Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth, the Complete Edition, 60% off for $19.99. Now this is an amazing RPG set in the Digimon universe. And I was a fan of Digimon growing up, but here in the West, we rarely got the best Digimon games. And at first, that's why it took me a while to actually warm up and try this game out, because I was discounting it for a long time. But you know what? I was wrong. This is actually a really solid entry, both for fans of Digimon, and if you just like JRPGs in general, where you're training monsters, you could actually really get into this game without actually being a fan of the series. Now, next on the list, we have a game that I talk about a lot, and that is Yoku's Island Express, 75% off for only $4.99. Now, this is a 2D Metroidvania, but with pinball-like mechanics. I know it sounds crazy, but it is actually an amazing game. And I was late on the pickup for this one as well. And the reason I talk about it so much is I want people to buy this because I'm really hoping one day for a sequel. It is that good. If you need to convince yourself once again, this one also has a free downloadable demo. But trust me, if you're into 2D platformers or Metroidvanias, try Yoku's Island Express. I've rarely seen someone who hasn't fallen in love with it. Now, another game that I talk about a lot, but I'm so glad to say is getting a new lowest ever price. That is Blossom Tales The Sleeping King at 75% off for $3.74. I've said it pretty much every time. If you're a fan of top-down Zelda games from the SNES era, you will definitely enjoy Blossom Tales. Obviously, the game isn't as long as full as a full-blown Zelda game, but nonetheless, at $3.74, you get way more than your money's worth and some really awesome gameplay. On once again, I'm gonna say it, free downloadable demo if you need to try it out. Now next, we have an entry for our action RPG fans, Tales of Vesperia, the Definitive Edition, at 75% off for $12.49. Now, if you've never played a Tales game before, it is a very long-running JRPG series that is basically set with an action genre. And honestly, Tales of Vesperia, the one we got on the Switch, is an excellent entry in the series. And you're getting a ton of content for only $12.49. So if you haven't played this one yet and you love action RPGs, definitely check it out. Now the next entry will be for fans of My Hero Academia, with My Hero 1's Justice 2 at 60% off for $23.99. Now the first one is also on sale that we'll be looking at a little bit later, and it's even cheaper. So if you haven't picked up either of the games, I would say start with the first one. If you like it a lot, you can pick up the second one later. The fun of this game is just basically bashing it out as different characters from the My Hero Academia series. The game is well done, the animations are beautiful, but once again, if you're not a fan of the series, this maybe is one to skip. Now the next entry on our series is going to be One Piece Pirate Warriors 3D Deluxe Edition. This is basically Warriors type gameplay in the One Piece universe. And currently at 80% off for only $7.99, I say that One Piece Pirate Warriors 3D Deluxe Edition is the best pickup this week for fans of One Piece. We're gonna look later that the fourth one is also on sale, but it is fairly more expensive than this entry. So if you haven't played either of the games, I would say pick up the third one. You get amazing amounts of content out of it. And if ever you want to move on because you like the gameplay, you can pick out the fourth one on the next time it goes on sale. Now next on our list, we have God Eater 3, another excellent entry for this week. And this is really, I would say, almost a Monster Hunter type game, but with a very anime-esque setting and storyline behind it. Now at 75% off for $14.99. Once again, this is another amazing pickup for anyone into 3D action games and that likes the concept of basically facing down huge, intense monsters, taking their body parts, building better weapons, and killing bigger monsters. Sound familiar? Yeah, it did to me too. But you know what? This series has its own charm and its own thing. It only is slightly based on the Monster Hunter concept. Now, if you need convincing for yourself, once again, free downloadable demo for this one. Now, next on the list, I mentioned it a little bit earlier, we have One Piece Pirate Warriors 4, 60% off for $23.99. Now, this isn't a bad price. It's just as I said earlier, I won't repeat myself too much. I find that the third one is better value, but if you play through the third one, you know you love the Warriors type gameplay in the One Piece universe. Fourth one is an excellent pickup, and at 60%, I would say that this is definitely now a good price. Now next, an amazing game to pick up this week is going to be Ollie Ollie Switch Stance. That is 80% off at only $2.99. Now if you're looking for an awesome budget entry for this week, this is most likely going to be your game. It's a 2D skateboarding game with some really amazing stages, amazing visuals, and amazing controls. Honestly, if you are looking for another game to take a chance on this week because you don't know what to pick up and you don't want to spend a lot of money, I would definitely say that Ollie Ollie Switch Stance is going to be one of your best pickups. So next on the list, I mentioned it a little bit earlier, we have My Hero One's Justice, the first entry at 75% off for $14.99. Now I'm not going to go into all the details again, but as I said, if you haven't picked up either one of the games, this is my better value pick for the week, if not the second one we looked at just a little earlier. Now next on our list is going to be another amazing game, Hob the Definitive Edition at 40% off for $11.99. Now this is an amazing 3D action adventure game, very reminiscent of Zelda type like gameplay, let's say Ocarina of Time. Once again, this one has a free downloadable demo, but trust me, if you're into 3D adventure games, you will definitely like Hob the Definitive Edition. Now next we have one of my all-time favorite 2D platformers on the Nintendo Switch, Monster Boy and the Cursed Kingdom, that is 60% off at $15.99. Now this is a game with slight Metroidvania elements also thrown in, where basically you play a character who can switch between different animal forms to basically tackle different objectives. Honestly, it's an amazing game. If you haven't played it yet, you're into 2D platformers. Obviously, at its full price of $40, it is quite expensive, but right now at $15.99, it's an excellent time to pick it up. Now, on the other hand, if you like your 2D platformers tough as nails, well, I have one for you, Tanuki Justice, 40% off, $8.99. Now, this is a 2D action platformer slash bullet hell type of game, and honestly, it is not that long, but it's going to take you quite a while to finish it because you pretty much have to learn each stage by heart to be able to eventually make your way through the game. Not only that, but the animations are beautiful, the gameplay is smooth, the controls are very responsive. Once again, a definite pickup for anyone who's a fan of 2D challenging platformers. Now we only have a couple of games left, but I would say the last two are definite not misses for this week. And the first one is going to be Sparklight at 60% off for $9.99. Now I know on the Switch we have a lot of 2D dungeon crawling roguelikes, but Sparklight is among the best we have. So if you're into that genre, you're looking for a new game to pick up, you haven't picked this one yet, at 60% off for $9.99, it is really amazing value. And the last entry on my list for this week will be the Vessara Collection at 50% off for $4.99. If you're a fan of shoot 'em ups, especially retro style shoot 'em ups, this is a not miss collection at only $5. You get both Vessara 1, Vessara 2, and a new entry that was completely remade in the same genre but with modernized gameplay and that is played in full HD, taking up the full screen. Basically, amazing shoot 'em ups and really an awesome throwback to a retro collection that we didn't really get to see in the West. So that is pretty much it for this week's list of great eShop deals. Let me know what you picked up down below in the comments. And as I said earlier, keep your eyes peeled for E3 coverage. We already know Nintendo has announced a massive sale for Tuesday. Also, I really want to thank the members of the channel. Memberships are now open. We have already a few people that signed up, and their names will be available in the credits of the video. And lastly, on the way out, don't forget that if you do want to support the channel, just please hit the like button, subscribe if you aren't already. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when all my new videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see all of you in my next video.